Hi guys, welcome back. Trip to the moon. Last week, I shot a high definition moon using the EOS R5 without any special gear. It's quite popular in the social media. Compared to the previous lunar shot I did using EOS 1DX Mark II, the detail and clarity are significantly improved. In this video, I will show you the whole process from shooting to post-processing. Also, I've included timestamp links in the description below. If you'd like to review and revisit any particular session, you can click the timestamp and directly link to the session. I love shooting the moon. It is mystery and glamorous. Though the size of the sun is about 400 times larger than the moon, they look about the same size. You know, you may see it at night, but sometimes you can see it during the daylight. The lunar phase of the moon makes its observable shape ever-changing. I bet there are more poems about the moon than the sun. This shooting does not require any astrophotography gear. I use the EOS R5 and the 400mm with the X2 extender. In the post-processing, apart from the Adobe Lightroom, all the software involved are freeware. I've included all the software links below, and all the artifacts to the Dropbox. Feel free to use the materials. You can follow the steps and practice yourself. The whole process involves three steps, that is, setup, shooting, and post-processing. For me, the whole process is around 1.5 hours. Setup 5 minutes, shooting 50 minutes, and the post-processing is around 1 hour. The moon is smaller than you see. The full moon is just about 30 odd minutes. I bet you want to shoot the beautiful moon with your mobile, but it only appears a tiny spot on the screen. We need a long focal length lens to shoot. The lens I use is EF100 to 400mm L IS2 USM with the X2 extender. Show the effective focal length is 800mm. Because of the long focal length, we should use a steady tripod to support it. The moon is brighter than you think. We should use histogram to avoid any clipping. Make sure the histogram spans around the middle to the lower half. The setting I use is 1 over 100 second, f11, and ISO is 1000. Once you focus the moon, suggest changing it back to the manual focus. It is to avoid any unexpected focus during the shooting. The moon moves fast on your camera screen. Technically, it is due to the Earth rotation, although you can use the tracking mask to offset motion. I will not use that in this video. In my case, I shot a 800mm and the moon takes around 7 minutes to move across from the bottom to the top of the screen. If you shot at 5 seconds interval, it can take 84 continuous shots without moving the camera. However, if we shoot video at 25 frames per second for 10 seconds, there are 250 frames. That's the reason we shoot video rather than continuous shot for planetary imaging. Here is a summary of my setting. The size of the 24 seconds video is around 1.25 gig. I've uploaded the video to the Dropbox, and you can find the link in the description. I use three software for the post-processing: PIPP, extract and do some pre-processing, Registest to align, stack and sharpening, and Adobe Lightroom to do the final touch up. Both PIPP and Registest has Windows version only. I'm a Mac user, so I will use the Parallels desktop to open it. PIPP is to extract the frame from the video file. Select the file at source file, pick the MP4 video file. You can check the total frames, FPS, size, and the days in the table. It will also pop up the upper frame window, which you can minimize it now. At the bottom of the screen, select Solar Lunar Full Disk. In PIPP, those controls that may need your attention will be green in color. Then you can go to the next tab, Input Options, to check anything interesting. the date time extraction does not apply to the MP4 video. Next, go to the Processing Options tab. You would like a color moon, so make sure to uncheck the convert color to monochrome. I will post the image to the Facebook so that I will crop it to 2048 pixel by 2048 pixel. Then check the quality option tab. I check the option of only keep the best quality frames and select the percentage of the frames to keep to 50. In other words, we only keep half of the extracted frames. Some of the frames quality may not be good because of the atmosphere seeing condition and the cloud. Skip the animation options. In the output options, select the TIFF format and include the quality value in the file name. In the last tab, do processing. Click the start processing. Then grab some drink and sit back. I'm using a 2019 Maxell 16-inch MacBook Pro and it took around 570 seconds to process, which is around 10 minutes. You can see that it extracted around 800 frames, discard half of it and only keep 298 frames. Then we can visit the output directory and check those 298 TIFF files. Next, we need to use the registers to align, stack and enhance. Similar to PIPP, it is Windows software and I run it through Parallels Desktop. You can find the software links in the description below. First, click Select and select all 298 TIFF files. Click Yes to stretch intensity levels. You can click the top Show Full Image to fit the image in the preview pane. All the default parameters should work fine. Click Set Align Points. In Registax, the action button will be underlined with a bright green line. That's the hint for your next action. After that, the Align button will have a bright green underlined. Again, the default parameters should work. Click the Align button. It took my MacBook Pro around 2 minutes to complete it. At the moment, the Limit button has a green underline. Click on it and you will enter the stack steps. The top stack button has green underlined. Click the top show full image to fit the image in the preview pane. Click the stack button and wait for a while. It took my MacBook Pro around 2 minutes to complete the process. Next, click on the wavelet tab. Adjust the layer values. You can use mine as a reference. You can click on the preview window and it will process a sample squared only. You can also click on the Do All button to apply the settings to the whole image. If you are okay with it, click the Save Image to save the final processed image. Remember to set the type to TIFF. If you are using it through the Parallel Desktop, you may encounter the system error. Let me share the trick with you. You can save it to C drive instead. Then, click the Save button again, navigate to the C drive, right-click to save the file, and select Cut. Then choose your destination directory and click Paste. Final touch-up. Open the Adobe Photoshop. Yes, I admitted I lied about only using the Adobe Lightroom. It is because the Lightroom cannot handle the 16-bit TIFF natively, so we have to open it in the Photoshop and save it to the PSD format. Then import it to the Lightroom. In the develop tab, my favorite is to do the auto tone as the first step. Then turn up reasonably in the texture, clarity, dehaze. Click remove chromatic aberration. Although the details of the moon surface is improved, the moon looks flat. My trick is to add a radial filter, the same size as the moon, and align the center with it. Set it to a darker exposure and depends on the moon phase. Move the center to the filter accordingly to make it look more 3D. Zoom in and you will find a bluish fringe around the border. It happens sometime after the wavelet enhancement in the registers. It can be fixed easily by suppressing the luminance by using the dropper. That's it. We have created a high definition moon image without any special gear.
I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, remember to click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thanks, and see you next time.